they're trying to use AI to save on costs. If you can get your costs down and your production up, it's a win-win. More profit, more traffic. It's not just going to stop with Insider. You can probably do a lot on your own now without even raising a dollar.
All right, so we are going to talk about how Insider is starting to experiment with AI. They're basically starting like a little Skunk Works. And Skunk Works is usually like you have a team that is designed to disrupt what you're currently doing as a company. And starting Thursday, members of Insider's newsrooms can apply to be a part of the working group that will test different ways to leverage AI across all of Insider's journalism products.
They're trying to use AI to save on costs. If you end up using AI, you can get more done from your people, especially when it comes to a business that's heavily reliant on content creation. If you can get your costs down and your production up, you in theory should get more traffic. It's a win-win. More profit, more traffic.
So what's going to happen? The kids, I'm quoting right now, the young people, they're going to learn AI very quickly. They're going to adapt. And what's going to happen? Companies are incentivized to want to cut on costs to drive profitability, especially if they have investors. So it is what it is. We're going to see a lot more of this.
Yeah, and it's not just going to stop with things like Insider using it to figure out how to create more content. It's going to be used with marketing agencies or even companies being like, huh, we pay this big team to analyze our analytics on a daily basis. We can use AI to figure out a lot of this stuff. And instead of having a team of 20 to do this, we can have a team of 3. Or they're going to be like, huh, we have all these graphic designers and creative people cranking out content for social media for us. Now with all these tools like Midjourney, we can end up doing 5 times the amount of work with a fraction of the people. So now we're going to, you know, weed down our creative department to just 1 or 2 people. Because what you'll see is these tools are going to help companies get more output with their marketing, and they're going to be able to do that in a more cost-efficient way, which is going to increase margins.
I believe the way we do business is going to change fundamentally. So one, you would see companies with thousands of people. Maybe it's down to hundreds, or maybe it's down to the teens. And the amount of money you need to raise as a startup or even start to build a product is no longer in the tens of millions or even millions. Maybe it's in a couple hundred grand or so.
Or you may not even need to raise money. You can probably do a lot on your own now, and you can get a proof of concept out and get feedback without even raising a dollar, because hosting and some of those things don't cost much, and you're going to start seeing more pressure from investors to show you more before you even raise a dollar from them.
And that's a good thing, because now investors will say, hey, show me proof of concept and show me you actually have traction, because that will become the baseline. Talk about data analytics too. Like data analytics salaries, we're talking data science salaries, are really expensive. If I were trying to pull apart data and get insight on Neil's millions of visits a month or his answer to public tool, I might just plug my data into that, plug it into the OpenAI API, because computers probably can do that better.
Dude, here's the best part. So on ubersuggest, we're on AWS. We've been having calls with Google and their cloud team. And they're just like, hey, if you switch to us, we'll give you a discount. You'll save quite a bit of money. We'll help with the migration. You don't have to worry about migrating the tech stack or anything. We'll do it all for you. But what was interesting wasn't the money savings, although I do like that. What was interesting is they were saying, hey, you have tons of data. We have a lot of different models on our end, but it'll help slice and dice your data for you. You can ask questions, and we can end up spitting out answers by computing your data and giving you insights that you didn't have before. That was interesting. Like, just think about what could be done with AI. You know, for us to do that before, one of our guys who works with us, Carlos, wanted a budget of around $550,000 or $580,000 a year to have a team of people just slicing and dicing our data and getting insights so we can create more thought leadership type of content. But now imagine doing this all with Google's cloud solution and doing it for free.
You know what's crazy too? I forgot to mention this part, Neil. Someone offered on Twitter, they hit me up, and the Morning Brew founder responded to something along the lines of, so this, what this tool does is it will pull, imagine pulling all the marketing school episodes that we've done, and it will just automatically create tweets for us, and it'll also create the images too, and it'll create carousels as well.
Yep. No, and what's cool is with AI, it can dissect all the really cool stuff from the content that we're producing, and we can just take those tidbits, because you can say, hey, what do you think people like to learn about the most from our content? and then take those tidbits and put it on social and see how it does. And I don't think it's really perfect right now to really help us grow our traffic, but within a year or two, it'll get much better.
Now, if you have any questions, leave a comment below. I'm here to answer them and help you out. If you enjoyed the video, like it, share it, tell people about it. Thank you very much.